Hello there, fellow YouTubers and fellow toy train lovers. This is your friend, the Jack of All Trades, Commodore Urban. And I'm really tired as fuck right now. It's about a quarter after 10. I've been busy busting my ass all day working. Not too long ago, got done running my trains, had a blast with my post-war, and, you know, it's been fun. Ever since I got them fixed, I've been enjoying them, and enjoying everything I have, and stuff, and whatever, and I figured I might tell you guys a little bit about my fascination with trains and where it came from. It actually was a question somebody asked, and I forget who it was, and it was like, where did your fascination for Lionel trains come from? So I figured, well, might as well tell you guys. You know, it's kind of a little bit of a story. So might as well tell y'all. The story starts back probably, let's see, probably 1995. I was 3, getting ready to turn 4, and my parents thought they'd take me to a hobby shop up in Indianapolis. And I remember that hobby shop at the time. I think it's still there now, but it was called Train City. And they took me in there, and that's when I first saw Lionel trains. Everywhere, there's like several aisles, everywhere you looked, it was this iconic blue and yellow, the blue and orange of Lionel. And as a kid, seeing these toy trains that were like, you know, as a kid they were huge, my eyes just widened up, and I said, Mommy, Daddy, that's what I want. I want a Lionel train. And it wasn't just a Lionel train I saw, because as a kid I loved Thomas the Tank, and I found a Thomas the Tank engine set made by Lionel with O-Gage. I said, Mommy, Daddy, that's what I want. And so my birthday came along. Sadly, I didn't get the train, and that's kind of where it all started, my fascination and my obsession with Lionel trains that still endures to this day. But I did get something for my birthday, though, that really fueled the fire. My mom bought a VHS copy of the Tom Acomas film, The Magic of Lionel. And I remember those gentlemen on that video, and I remember one particular. His name is Carl Burkhart. He had a small Lionel layout. It was all post-war, but it was filled with a lot of action, and it was just fun. And I still can remember that layout, and I thought, you know, with the space I have in my room, I thought, I want to build a layout like that, small but full of action. But anyway, over the years, as a kid, every year on my Christmas list, I always had written down Lionel train set. Even train sets change, and you know, I wanted the Thomas set, and then there was another train set now. That was the Great Train Robbery set. It was like a western type train, and it had like a little hand car with two robbers on that chased it. I wanted it, and there was a bunch of other ones, but it wasn't until 2008 that I got my first train set, and it was the 50th anniversary Pennsylvania Steam Freight from Target. And you know, all those years of wanting a Lionel train set, in that year I got one. It was like the greatest thing in the world. It was like I finally got the one thing I always wanted. And so, you know, it was awesome. And it was a few years later after that, like 2013, from my 22nd birthday, I got my Chicago Northwestern freight set. And so in a few more years after that, like 2017, it was August, that's when I bought my Lionel 2016 locomotive with the 6026W tender. And then go a few months later, Christmas of 2017, I got my 1547S freight set from 1856. And strap today, you know, this is what I have right there. Say, and after that, fast forward a few months afterwards, my birthday of 2018, I got the New York Central RS3 Lion Chief freight set. And so yeah, it's kind of how my collecting and stuff goes, and you know. But there have been many years, though, as a kid, I never had a Lionel train set. I only seen them in books and stuff like this one here. I had this book since I was about 8 or 9, and it's basically a reference book for all pre-war trains. And yes, there are some pre-war trains I'd like to have. And primarily the trains I want, the pre-war era ones, include the if you can see it, City of Portland. I want the 4-car version. The Blue Streak. I've always wanted this one since I was about 6 or 7 years old. The Flying Yankee. This version here, the gunmetal and chrome. Not the black version. The City of Denver. I've always wanted one of those. And I've always wanted one of these 1700E ones with the cars in tow. I mean, there's other engines and crap I'd like to have, too. Pre-war ones. If I can find them here. There we go. I'd like to have a 150. A 252E. A 254E and a 256. A 253 would be nice to have too. I'd like to have one of those. I'd like to have a 255E, a 258, a 259, the 260 with the chugger. I'd love to have one of those. The 263 Blue Comet, love to have one of them, and a 262, and of course, you know, your Hiawatha, I'd love to have a Hiawatha. I don't know, a 226E be nice to have, and of course, you know, the granddaddy of all of them, the 700E Hudson. I'd love to have a 700E Hudson, but I don't know if that's ever going to happen. That'd be one expensive-ass locomotive to find. And so with a 763, that'd be hard and shit to find, too. Be a hell of a lot easier to find one of these guys than one of those. And, of course, you know, Mickey Mouse hand car, that'd be cool to have, too. But those are hard and fuck to find, too. So, yeah. This is the book. Standard of the World, 1900, 1943, second edition. By the Train Collectors Association Lionel Book Committee. It's an old book. You can tell it's a very old book. But I've had that since I was like 6 or 7 years old. I got that from a gentleman who was a train collector. He gave that to me. So, yeah. So, yeah. Well, I hope that explains a little bit about my obsession with Lionel trains. Maybe kind of opens up a little bit to you guys, a little bit about me, and hope you enjoy it. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down below, and I'll try to get back to you. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, hit the subscribe button. I like that. I don't know how many subscribers I have. I think I have over 200 or 300. I know it's be 12, somewhere like 200-300 people. I don't know, it might be more, but you know, it just proves, hey, I guess I'm doing something right. So until next time, this is Calvin Urban saying, God bless you, and you guys have a good day. All right, see you soon.